So, I just logged on and I got a bunch of these things here in my house. And a second ago there were actually way more and they just escaped out here. Yeah. So I guess the pranking is on. Let's see what we can do about that. Hi there, my name is Marky Sparky, and this is the second episode of my brand new Let's Play series on the Everything is Awesome server. And that's right, we called it Everything is Awesome, which is of course an homage to the Lego movie, and if you know the song we are talking about, you know exactly what's up. In the last episode, I promised to build the skeleton XP farm using the spawner that is located right below where I'm standing at the moment, and I will get back to that in the second half of this episode. However, first of all, let's jump back to the chicken problem that we have at the moment. So I went down to my mine, while I was searching for all these chickens that somebody put in my house, and I realized that for some reason they all look for the highest point down here, and they all went up here to the skeleton spawner. And I have no idea whether this is intentional, but now they are all in here. And just a second ago they were all sitting on top of that spawner actually, which was hilarious. Unfortunately, I cannot show this to you now. Ah, maybe. Okay. Yeah, something like that. That's just hilarious. I have no idea what this is all about. Well, I guess they live here now. Quite some time has passed here and the chickens actually grew up, and what I plan to do now is to build a little sanctuary for these chickens. Right down here, next to my water elevator. Because here is actually quite a lot of space where I also got some obsidian from here. So what I want to do is just dig out here a bit and yeah, create a little sanctuary for all these chicken, and maybe also include some mechanism to collect all of their eggs to maybe return the prankage later. So I have created a little space for them, and I obviously use hoppers to collect all the eggs, but I mean that's not nice for the chickens to live on hoppers, right? So I plan on use some green carpet on top of the hoppers, and to get this green dye actually I had to travel quite far to a desert biome that somebody just discovered, and we have a rudimentary nether tunnel to there now. And so I got some green dye, and I hope I have a little bit of wool left. Okay, I have too much stuff in my inventory. Just give me a second here. So, what I have done now is this little space here. And I need lighting in here, so maybe just like that. And then I want to cover these hoppers here. So four of these hoppers that are all pointing in this direction to this chest here, where I then can collect all the eggs, and I actually have seven already because the chickens up there already laid eggs. Yeah, now here all the eggs are collected and I can access this, and I think they might be able to jump on top of that here. Well, doesn't matter, they can also go over here, and I want to actually put some coarse dirt here. I forgot that. Let's just get that. Let's just put that in here. Perfect. That's what I wanted. So I have all my seeds here. Unfortunately, up to now, nobody has found any slimes, so we cannot... they're coming. We cannot craft some leads to have this the more comfortable way here, but I mean, this works. This works perfectly. Now follow me in here. Come on. Just a little further. Maybe that's already enough. Let's... okay. You
How do I get you in there? Are you inside or outside? Huh? No. Wrong. Perfect. Yeah, I bring you guys back when this is finished, I guess. Okay, so I changed up the whole thing a bit because I really didn't like how it looked. And I wanted to connect the fences here to the walls, actually, but I made the mistake of removing that one fence post. And now they seem to look for the highest spot again. And now I have them all up here, which is bad because the hoppers to collect all the eggs are down here. And now I really don't know how to get them down there again. But in theory... Oh, I have one more egg here. So the whole thing is working. They are laying eggs and they are collected down here. But what to do about that now? So, this is what it looks now. I think this will be the final thing for now. I had to put one more leaf block in here so that they won't jump up there. And I replaced this one fence post with a fence gate here, so this looks a bit nicer. This is actually unnecessary now, but without it, it seems like there's a gap here, which there isn't, but it looks like it, and I don't like that. So, now they are down here, and they are producing eggs, and I hope they like it. Yeah, I think so. So, let's leave them with the egg laying, and maybe later on we can collect that and use it in some kind of prank. And I'm really looking forward to that. I have decided to build a little basic starter cactus farm down here, right next to the chicken pen, because I think there are shops already selling all the flowers that we can collect around here, but yeah, there's basically no cacti and thus no green dye that is sold yet. And yeah, why not build a little small starter cactus farm? So what I want to do here is have five... Actually, let's do that right now. Have five spots where we can grow the cacti. Here. And we will have water streams down here, funneling all the cacti down here, and we collect them here with some chests. And basically how this will work is when the when one of these cactuses grows, it will come into contact with these fence posts, and what will happen then is it will just drop off. I think you might know this, and then it can be collected down here. And I actually want to stack this. So I want to have another one up there. I hope this is... actually, I don't think this will work. Okay, so the idea of stacking the two rows of cacti won't work, because obviously I would have to continue this line of fences here up to the top, and yeah, at some point I will be exactly here, and then I cannot put the cactus here in the first place. This works with a design from, for example, Il Mango, where you put... how are they called now? End rods, right. Where you put end rods here, where the on the height level of the cactus, and it won't break. And then you continue with the fence posts above the end rod, but we haven't been to the end yet, so this won't work. So I think I will not stack it vertically, but I will have another row right here, so I have it horizontally, and then I won't run into these problems. I really don't know if this was such a good idea. The chicken noises are already getting on my nerves here. But it works. So, this is what I have now. I have two rows of five cacti and water streams below, and everything is collected down there in a hopper, and yeah, put in this chest here. And yeah, we already have the first cacti down here. This is not such an elegant solution here, because I always have to go down there to open this chest, and then I fall down the hole when I walk right here. So I might think about a different solution for that. Maybe have an item elevator somewhere and have the chest here in the wall or something. But for now this works, and this is the first farm that I have built in this series, and yeah, that's nice. Well, unless you might consider this the first farm, but yeah, I really don't want to consider this a farm, because this is a sanctuary, right? 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 So guys, in the last episode I talked about this mob spawner and that I'm planning to build a basic beginner's XP farm with it. So this is a skeleton mob spawner, and I already put some work in it and cleared this, what is it, 9 by 9 by I guess 9 space for the skeletons to spawn. And also I looked above on the surface where exactly the spawner is located. Let's just check that. So it is nighttime, and the spawner is right below this block here on Y level 27, and I think up here it's 66 or something. So I will have to see what I can do about that. However, you have to be in a 16 radius around. Is it radius? I think it is radius. In a 16 block radius around the spawner for the skeletons to spawn. And 16 blocks away is exactly here. Which is perfect, because here I want to build the building with maybe a water elevator down and up to and from the farm. So I will have a chamber down there somewhere in this vicinity. Which is perfect. And yeah, I plan to build this so that it is switchable from collecting all the items and collecting XP. And at the same time, I want all the items to end up in my own storage system down here, so I can sell that afterwards. And yeah, I have a few ideas on how to do that. I'm not quite sure how I can do it, because there's not enough space above that to the surface so the mobs can drop to their death. Maybe there is. I will have to see about that. But yeah, I will put some more work in. I will add the water streams here, and maybe the basic chamber for the mobs to, yeah, drop into, and I will bring you guys back when I have done a little bit more work on that. Okay, so I've done a little more work. I put in all the water sources here down at the bottom. I put these three stone blocks above it so that no skeletons spawn above the spawner and get stuck here. Yeah, all of the skeletons should make their way down here and then be transported here to this water column, where they get transported up almost to the surface and then drop down right next to it. So let's go over there. Let's actually break that, because then I want to test the whole thing. They should all drop down right here, and I want to see whether this works and whether the skeletons actually die when they fall down. Because I didn't really measure out how far this is now. So let's get rid of all the torches. Do I have any stone left? Do I have cobble? No, can't reach it. Yes. Let's go around here. Break this. And that. This. Can't get down there. That one. Those three. Four. And something spawned. Perfect. Okay, so let's get rid of these last torches. And then get out of here. Oh no, one more over there. They are transported over there. That's perfect. Let's close this up and see whether... Yes, hello there. And they are falling. I get all my items. That is nice. Yeah. There's something coming. Yeah. Come down here. Now it's come up. And it died. Perfect. Oh. Okay. That is quite nice. So I'm within the vicinity of the spawner so that it is active. All the skeletons are transported up there. Move over 4 blocks, I think, and drop down again and die. And hello there. Perfect. So what I want to do is now create a little chamber here where all the drops are then picked up, maybe by a hopper minecart below the block. So it is actually picked up faster than a player would pick up the items. And then we can make a switch to switch from item collections. Oh, even with armor they die here. That is perfect. And again, make a switch where I maybe drop a water source with a dropper in there at the right height so that they are decelerated when they fall down here. And then they might live with, I mean, ideally they would land here with half a heart or something so that somebody without a sword can kill them. If that doesn't work, well, but I want to have a switch like that in there. And this is great, so maybe I will just get a hopper and a chest so that I will already collect all the items that are dropping down here. Just for now. Yeah. So, perfect. I will bring you guys back when I have done a little more work on that. Well, it's the next day now and I had to stop playing yesterday and so I used the time to do some AFKing here at the farm. And well, first of all, I realized, which should be quite obvious actually, that all the skeletons that are wearing these feather falling boots are not dying in the farm. So every time after, I don't know, a few hours of AFKing, there's a bunch of these armored skeletons here and the farm is not running anymore. And I have to kill these off before it can continue. However, I still managed to get quite some goodies here. I have 2 double chests full of arrows actually already, and I think this is all the arrows that the server will ever need because we are all having these infinity bows anyway. But which is more important to me is I have a full double chest of bone blocks, and this is obviously very useful since we all need the bone meal and we have no other source of bone meal up to now. And also, I plan to use those for the design of the shop front or of the building that I'm going to build up there, which will be the end. Was that diamond boots? Well, unfortunately, we don't get them if we don't kill them. That looked like diamond. Well, Where was I? Yeah, so I plan to use these bone blocks for the building that I'm going to build up there. So what I have in mind is maybe a skull or something like that on top of the building, and maybe a big bow and arrow or something like that. And yeah, I think I'm going to go creative later on a single player world and just test this. However, I'm really happy about the amount of bone blocks that I could get from AFKing overnight. And also, if I don't need all of that, I can obviously sell that and make some profit maybe, which would be very nice. Well, this is going to be it for this second episode. Unfortunately, I do not have enough time to finish the whole skeleton XP farm building. However, there's always a next episode. If you enjoyed this one, give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. And as I said in the last one, I am very new to this. If you have any suggestions on how I can improve, basically anything, please leave me a comment down in the comment section. Thank you very much for watching and see you in the next one.